Hey guys, Chicago injury lawyer Scott DeSalvo here. And in today's video, the topic is, what if my own doctor, my own treating doctor, sends me back to work too early or won't support my workers' comp case? So I'm doing this topic because I got a message from a guy who watched one of my other videos about the dangers of treating with the company doctor in a workers' comp case. It doesn't always ruin your case, but anytime there's an economic incentive for the doctor to be loyal to the insurance company, the workers' comp insurance, and not to his patient, it's not going to work out right more often than not, right? Now, there are certain times where I don't disrupt treatment. You know, I'll tell somebody just stick with, I don't ever disrupt treatment. Like, I'm one of the few lawyers out there that I can tell that don't really like to get involved in my client's treatment. But, you know, if they ask me, the doctor's giving me a hard time, what should I do? A lot of times I'll tell them to switch if it's a company doctor, but there are certain circumstances where you don't, okay? But I address that in other videos. This video is about your own treating doctor, your family doctor, an orthopedic who you've been seeing for years for other things, and then you have a work injury or even a car accident or a fall down, and in that case, your treating doctor, who you thought was loyal to you, who you've been loyal to, who's always been good to you, is suddenly becomes adversarial. They send you back to work too soon. They don't want to support, you know, a causation opinion. A causation opinion is an opinion that your injury and problems or need for surgery or need for therapy is related to the accident, right? And so here's the straight dope. Why is this happening? The truth is that it used to be lawyers and doctors got along better. Now this, we're talking about 20 years ago and more than 20 years ago, okay? But from talking to some doctors that I know, doctors are actually being sort of indoctrinated in medical school to be anti-lawyer, anti-lawsuit, anti-injury claim. In other words, they tell you, you know, the so much of what we believe is based on where we are, like who we're around, what other people around us are saying, the general attitudes of people around us, right? So you have doctors who are in medical school, who are in this environment where lawyers are the butt of jokes or sharp commentary. Like, you can't trust them. They're all looking to sue you. They're all looking for, you know, a way to sue you for medical malpractice. They'll cheat you out of your bills if they can. And even though my opinion, obviously, I guess, as a lawyer, is that it's pretty rare that you have lawyers of that type that doctors run into, it doesn't take many lawyers of that type for a doctor to run into, you know, before doctors sour on lawyers altogether, don't want to have anything to do with them, don't want to have anything to do with an injury case. Another thing for you to know is it is very, very often the case that a doctor, particularly a surgeon, goes through their life with everybody kissing their butt, right? So before they went to medical school, it's very likely that they were the smartest kid in their family, one of the smartest kids in their schools. Everybody thought that they were, you know, oh, they're going to be a doctor. It's a very prestigious profession, especially a surgeon, right? Then they become surgeons and the nurses and all the people around them kiss their butts, whatever they want, whatever you want, doctor. And then they're in practice and then they meet with patients and the patients defer to the doctors, okay? So the patients defer to the doctors too. And what happens is the doctors are used to everyone deferring to the doctor, respecting the doctor. And then what happens is a doctor gets into a deposition and they get cross-examined and sharply questioned for the first time. And their findings are questioned and their bills are questioned and their decisions are questioned and their opinions are questioned. And for the first time in many of these doctors' lives, they're uncomfortable. They're matched up against somebody who is intelligent, really read the medical records, and is really pushing them and challenging them. And this is what I'm going to tell you. Most doctors hate it, and they will avoid, they'll do anything to avoid it. And so these are the two things that I think is the reason why family doctors, or just like the emergency room doctor, they don't like lawyers, they don't like lawsuits, because they're marinated in a negative environment about it. And maybe they have had a deposition where they just thought they'd go in and tell the truth, and they got savaged. And even if they didn't get savaged, it will feel like they got attacked to the doctor, because the environment the doctors live in is a little bit of a la-la land. Like, every job I've ever had, including being a lawyer, included people not being nice to me, yelling at me, and accountability. If I screw something up, you know, and some mean bosses, right? And I think all of us have had mean bosses, but I think a lot of doctors just haven't. And they're not used to anybody challenging them or their authority, and they don't like it. And as a result, they don't want to be involved in an injury case, they don't want to be involved in a lawsuit, and they sure don't want to get deposed. Now, obviously, that's not all doctors. Some doctors are willing to give depositions, and some of them are excellent at it. But that's why, whether it's a family doctor or whether it's a company doctor, usually family doctors can be better than company doctors. It is so important for you to treat with a doctor who is okay with working in an injury case, right? And if they're not okay with doing it, you're going to run into the problem that this guy who messaged me, you know, his doctor was sending him to work too early. And, you know, he told, you know, it was a shoulder injury. He had a restriction, and the doctor just wouldn't, you know, the company said, no, we don't have any one-handed work, but we want you to come back to work anyway. And so the doctor caved and sent him back to work full duty, even though he has a torn rotator cuff. And this isn't a company doctor. This is his very own doctor. So why would a doctor do something like that? That's what the video is about. I hate hearing stuff like that. When you're uncertain and you are injured and you want to get better, the least you ought to be able to expect is to have a doctor who's on your side. But like so many things in life, there's the way things are supposed to happen, and then the way they think the things really do happen. So I hope this insight into why treating with a family doctor may not be your best bet helps you. You know, one thing I can guarantee you, even if your doctor's not on your side, all of my clients have me and my entire team on their side. So we answer questions, we handle problems. I don't like to make my clients do legwork unless they want to get involved. So if you or a loved one has been injured, or you know anybody who needs a good lawyer, if you could send them my way, I'd truly appreciate it. Easiest way to do that is by calling 312-500-4500. Again, 312-500-4500. Call that number any day, any night, any time, 24-hour. What is it? 24/7, 365, meaning 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, except in leap year. I guess then it's 366 days a year. Great tools on my website if you're not ready to talk to a lawyer. I've got the case cash calculator. Gives you an idea of what your case might be worth in 15 seconds flat. You literally answer about 6 multiple choice questions real quick, spits out an answer, gives you some pretty good information, 100% free, no obligation, link in the description. I also have the Do I Have a Good Case calculator, same deal, quick, just a few multiple choice questions, takes you 10 or 15 seconds to complete, and it'll tell you whether you probably have a good case or you have a case with some challenges. Again, 100% free, link in the description. I do that to help injured people. If I can help you, give me a call. If you enjoy the video, please subscribe, hit the like button, share it if you'd like to. And if you enjoy the information I give and you wouldn't mind giving me a 5-star review on Google, it would really help me out. I'll leave a link in the description. It takes you 5 seconds. Literally, you just cut and paste the URL into the, you know, into your web browser, go there, click 5 stars, say a kind word, hit submit. Takes you 5 seconds, but it's invaluable and a wonderful favor that you can do for me. So thanks for watching. I hope you and the family are well, and Take care.